I guess anything for a check. What's going on, you guys? It's be your boy Scotty, and I'm here for another rant video. And this story is actually 2 weeks old, but I have been meaning to do this video. But you guys know that everything that's been going on in my personal life, you know, I lost my cousin the week this story actually came out, and then I buried my cousin the week after that. So that's why I really wasn't in the mood to do no videos like that. I only did my reviews and that was probably it. But I'm just trying to catch up on the things that I haven't discussed just yet. So what we're going to do is we're here to talk about Phaedra Parks, you know, the one that used to be on the Housewives of Atlanta. And I got this story from, let's see, blackamericaweb.com. So this is what the story said. And then after I read the article itself, I'm going to give y'all my thoughts, my opinions on what I think about this. Here we go. While Phaedra Parks won't be holding a peach anytime soon, there are reports and rumors that she'll appear on the next season of Marriage Bootcamp. According to TMZ, sources close to the production have confirmed that Phaedra is there with her new man, Medina Islam. The two have only been dating for several months, and there are some issues they like to hash out on the reality show. Reportedly, Phaedra is ready to leave Atlanta with her two sons in favor of Los Angeles, where Medina lives. The question is, are they ready to move in together, and how would their relationship progress from there? As we reported before, Islam is an actor who appeared on Tyler Perry's The Haves and the Have-Nots. Phaedra Parks said that after not dating for 4 years, she started looking around 9 months to a year ago. She said she found Medina on a celebrity dating app called Raya. He made the first move, reaching out to Parks. Islam is 10 years her junior, but Parks says he's very smart, very intelligent, he's kind, and we're both socially active. He's really sober and smart. He's a great father, so I'm excited about it. It would be interesting to see their dynamic on the show together. Now that Apollo is out of prison, I can see him having an issue with his sons being across the country. But perhaps that's a bit premature. We shall see. So that's the article on Phaedra Parks going to Marriage Bootcamp. Now here's what Scotty got to say about Phaedra Parks going to Marriage Bootcamp. I feel like this ain't about no damn relationship. This is all about another check. And it's not like Phaedra really needs the fucking check, to be quite honest. I mean, she ain't been with this nigga that long. She was just with some radio DJ a couple of months ago. And it's just like, okay, you already going on Marriage Bootcamp with this nigga and you ain't even been with him that long. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just trying to figure it out, because it's like, okay, girl, like, you talk about all these jobs you got, all these degrees you got, and this and that, and now you sitting up here getting on Marriage Bootcamp, and for no reason at all, really, because it's not about no relationship. You ain't been with this nigga that long. It's just like me going on Marriage Bootcamp with the dude that I be talking to. You know what I mean? It's just like me going on Marriage Bootcamp with his ass, and I've only been talking to him for X amount of time. So why the fuck would I be going on, why the fuck would she be going on Marriage Bootcamp for him? Y'all ain't been together. You and Quincy, because that's what he played on The Haves and the Have-Nots. You and Quincy ain't been on The Haves and the Have... shit, I about to say, you and Quincy ain't been on The Haves and the Have-Nots. You and Quincy ain't been together that long for y'all to have some deep-rooted issues for y'all to be on Marriage Bootcamp. To be honest, Phaedra and Medina gonna be just like Lil Fizz and Tiffany. Them motherfuckers knew they wasn't in a relationship. They knew they needed the check and they needed the money, and they decided to bring their asses on this motherfucking show just to get some airtime in a check. And this is what this is about, to be quite honest. I mean, I just don't see it. The way that Phaedra carries herself, I don't see her wanting to move out of the city, out of the state, all the way to the other side of the other damn country to be with a man that she's only known for a couple of months when she just got out of another relationship. So I just don't see that. I don't know. I really don't know. I don't know what her life is. I don't know what she's doing right now. I could care less to know, because she ain't my favorite. But I just don't see her really doing this just to make their relationship better. She's only been with him for X amount of months. And then, like I said, she just got out of a relationship with the radio DJ. Both men are good looking men. I will say that although this bitch is a fraud and I don't like her like that, she has a way of choosing a man, because these men that she choose are the shit. Nah, that's just how I feel with that. But I don't know. Now, you know, y'all know I did do reviews on Marriage Bootcamp last season. I did, and those were great reviews. But I did say I had already made up in my mind that I was going to review this upcoming season of Marriage Bootcamp when I saw Shonda and Willie from Love & Hip Hop fame and also Hazel E from Love & Hip Hop fame. So I said, you know what, I'm going to review this show again this coming up season. And now that Phaedra is coming on the show, I know I'm going to review it now. So it is what it is. So, what are y'all thoughts on this? Do y'all think that Phaedra is only on here for a check and for some visibility for whatever it is she got going on? Or do you really believe that her and this dude that she's only been with for 3 days are really having issues and they really want to come on the show to fix said issues? And what do y'all think about the relationship? Do y'all think that she should be moving across the country to be with a man that she's only known for 3 days? What do you think about this? I don't know, but give y'all opinions on that. That being said, you guys, listen, I'm finna go to Chick-fil-A and get me some food. And then when I come back from Chick-fil-A, I'm finna go back and watch that boring ass Love & Hip Hop Hollywood episode, because I wasn't gonna do no review on that shit. But y'all want me to do it, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. I gotta watch it again so I can get y'all a review. But other than that, this is my rant. I might do another rant later. I just might do another rant later. We'll see. But with that being said, this is my rant. And let's talk below. Please, let's keep the dialogue very respectful. We can agree to disagree, but please do not come in trying to be, you know, motherfucking mad because I'm saying what I'm saying about your fave. Because whenever I say, y'all know, when I say something about certain people, whether it's Phaedra, whether it's Portia, whether it's Nicki Minaj, whether it's Evelyn, whether it's Evelyn, whether it's fucking Jennifer Williams, bitches get mad when I get my opinion. So let's keep it respectful. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really want everybody to be able to state their opinion and just give it, and you know. And plus, I want to engage more with my comment section. The only reason why I don't engage that much with my subscribers in my comment section because of damn negativity. People that just don't know how to just disagree, and let's have a mature conversation. Let's just do that. But with that being said, you guys, I'm out of here. Let's go. Talk to y'all later. Peace.